As a young woman, I swore that when I seen injustice, inhumanity, cruelty to another human person, that I would not remain silent.
כשמונה חודשים לאחר שסיימו את משט סולידריות מברצלונה לעזה, התכנסו נשות המשט בפרלמנט השוודי והציגו את מצב תושבי עזה, ובפרט את מצבן של הנשים תחת המצור.
Governments fail to undertake serious and concrete action. It is the people of conscience, like you, who rise and counter persistent violations. And we remain indebted to you for working to achieve peace and justice on behalf of the Palestinian people.
My suffering is like everyone in Gaza. It's my mother's, not personal. My mother's sickness. She's suffering from asthma like 11 years old, years ago. She can't find the proper medicine here in Gaza.
בהיותן תחת סגר, נשים מעזה לא יכלו להשתתף בכנס. אך קולן הועבר באמצעות וידאו, בו הן הציגו את המצוקות ההומניטריות שלהן. משתתפות המשט חלקו את חוויותיהן מול הצבא.
We were strip searched 2 or 3 or 4 times. Every place we went, our bags went through metal detectors. This was a minimal experience in relation to what Palestinians go through every day. But you could feel the intensity of that degradation on your human dignity, even as it was done kindly, politely, and people would turn around and say, no, we did everything we were supposed to do. We didn't get our phone call. So there was a moment when all the ambassadors of almost everybody else was there. We were in a courtyard. Every one of our comrades were sitting outside with the consular representatives, myself, Dr. Fauzia and Samira were put into a cage right there by the and I was saying, why are we in a cage when everyone else is sitting here talking to their consular representatives? And they said, you are in a cage. And in that moment, Samira said something to me. She said, in this moment, we are a little bit closer to our Palestinian brothers and sisters. Because we are wearing a hijab, because we are brown, because we don't have our government supporting us, they will put us in a cage and make us feel terrible.
Talk about Gaza. I've been in Gaza and on the dignity boat in 2008. We got into Gaza. And what we saw in Gaza was the airport bombed to the ground by the Israeli military. What we saw in Gaza when we arrived at the hotel was the man saying to us, you're only the second people who've crossed the sea in 40 years to come into our hotel. We have been completely cut off from the world. This is not acceptable in a civilized world, and we demand those in power break their silence. Because if they have a conscience and they can go to sleep at night and think of little children in Gaza and in Palestine not having a future, my God,
נשות המשט ומשתתפות הכנס קוראות לסולידריות עם תושבות ותושבי עזה, סיום הסגר על העיר והשכנת שלום המבוסס על הומניות ואמפתיה.